Hello everyone, welcome back to another lecture. And the module which we will cover now is related to the process flowsheet. So this activity is related to combining all the unit operations which we have modeled separately. And now we will combine these units and we will simulate these. Now what is a tear stream? When Aspen Plus is running in the traditional sequential modeler, if you see that sequential means that it will be solving sequence wise, means initially the number one equipment will be solved, then number two, then number three, and so on. So in this case, the streams are connected, but no recycling. But when any recycling is involved, when any recycle stream is involved, it will be solved iteratively. That iterations will be carried out to solve the recycle stream. And when recycle stream is involved, then the tear stream concept is created. If there is no recycle, no tear. If you need to recycle something, for example, in extractive distillation technique, you need to recycle solvent back. So there, the tear stream concept will come. Aspen Plus selects tear streams for these iteration. The iteration starts with the tear stream, obviously. The iteration will start with the tear stream, the recycle stream. However, if user has initialized the tear stream, initialization means you have given the starting values of temperature, pressure, flow. If you have given some values, Aspen will start from that point. But if you have not given any value and if it is starting from zero, then there is a chance that the number of iterations, you might need to increase these values. Or if your solution is not achieved by increasing the number of iterations, then you have to specify some initial guess. And then based on this guess, Aspen will give you the right solution. If the user has initialized the tear stream, these flows, temperature and pressure will be used as the starting point. Otherwise, the calculations will start with zero values. And it is the point where there is a maximum chance that you will not get any answer. Hence, it is important to initialize tear streams because the model may not converge if starts from zero. So, water, methanol, ethanol, and ethylene glycol. Then click on next and select NRTL. RK is the property package. After that, click on next and estimate using UNIFAC and click run. And once after running, results are available. Go to the simulation block and do the flow sheeting part basically. So what you do, you first need the heat exchanger placed over here. Then you need the flash separator placed over here. Then you need the distillation column and it is also placed over here. Now, this one is the feed. Initially, you can use nomenclature of your own choice. It's up to you. Then this vapor is entering here. This liquid is leaving here. Then another stream is entering over here, which is the glycol. This is the distillate and this recycle stream. And you see all the connections have been completed. You can simply align all of these if you want. And this feed, which is the S1. So you can see 165 degree Fahrenheit, 15 psi, 100 k mol per hour with mass fraction 0.4, 0.3, and 0.3. And this is the first time you can see that you are using multiple units. Means this is the English unit, this is SI unit, but in mole. And here you are giving the mass value. So this can also be given to you as well. Specify another feed stream, which is the ethylene glycol. So you see, ethylene glycol is also added 70 degree Fahrenheit, 35 psia, and 50 pound mole per hour flow rate. You can also specify flow rate over here and composition over here. It's clearly up to you. Now, go to this heat exchanger, and in design, you can see that you cannot specify the exchanger area. You can specify a maximum of heat exchanger duty, but you cannot specify exchanger area while going in calculation mode design. So you have to shift to calculation mode as simulation, and then you can specify the heat exchanger area, which is 65 square feet and with one value. Obviously, you know its degree of freedom is one, so it is tick. After that, go to this flash separator and you know its degree of freedom is two. Pressure, we have been given that delta P is zero. When delta P is zero, it means the pressure at inlet and the pressure at outlet will be zero, but you have been given the pressure. There is no information about the pressure drop, but pressure at inlet and pressure at outlet. So you can simply specify 0 psia, or you can see it is at 15 psia. So you can either specify 15 psia or simply enter 0 psia, same meaning. But the unit should be same, obviously, to avoid the pressure drop. Pressure drop 0, duty 0. Now go to this distillation column. There are 10 number of stages. Condenser type is total. Distillate to feed ratio is 0.2, which is in mole, and reflux ratio is 5. After that, we have to specify the feed streams. Both are 5, and the convention to be used is on stage. It is in PSIA converted to ATM. After that, simply click run. And once after running, you see that results are available, but with warning. What are the warnings? This B1, which is heat exchanger, at least one feed has zero flow, as shown there. And what was that stream? This S7 or there B1. And then this B3, which is the final distillation column, feed contains only one component. If I take you to this flash separator and we see whether there is anything in S3, you can see S3 is clearly empty. No flow rate, no feed is going to distillation column from S3, S1, S2, S4. S3 is completely zero. So it means there is only one component, which is ethylene glycol. So now what to do? It has given you problem that the warning in B1 and B3, and it is not convergence. Block is not converged. So what you do? You need to specify this S7. You need to give initial estimates of this S7 stream, because if you look at this B1, it is saying that at least one feed has zero flow, which it could be. If you apply your knowledge, you have specified S1. The other feed stream is S7. So obviously, this S7 zero hai. Aur agar aap idhar dekhen to S3 mein kuch nahi ja raha. Iska matlab hai yahan pe heating hi nahi ho rahi. Jab heating nahi ho rahi, to yahan pe flashing nahi ho rahi. Jab flashing nahi ho rahi, to S3 mein kuch bhi nahi ja raha. Jiski wajah se overall problem aa raha. To agar aap S7 ke initial estimate de denge, kuch na kuch, to ye converge kar jayega. So what you do? Specify some initial estimates of S7 by clicking input and give the value of temperature. For example, if it is something about 160 something, so it is at 200 degree Fahrenheit and something 15 PSIA or 14.7 PSIA. 14.7 PSIA is also fine. Then initially you can specify 75. It's a rough estimate. Obviously we have calculated that how much water is present in the feed, which is S1, given some of it. So once after running, you see results are now available. So with this guess, you have converged all of the system. That you need to specify initial parameters of this stream. Now go to the results of the stream, and obviously the results cannot be the same. You have just given a starting point. You had specified the pound mole of water as 70. However, it has calculated the pound mole of water as 4.9. So you see there is a whole difference, but with your some initial estimates, it has converged. Obviously the flow temperature you have specified is 200, but it is 333.983, then 14.7 approximately the pressure. So that's how you simulate blocks in the flow sheeting and then applying the concept of tear stream on the recycle stream. Activity number 2 of this module, linked with all CLOs of this course, which is fundamental, simulation, process flow sheeting, and analysis. So successfully converge a flow sheet using tear stream and recognize the way of using tear stream in Aspen Plus. These are the two objectives of this simulation. So methanol water, the famous combination we have already studied several times, is added with property packages NRTL. Then click on next, estimate using UNIFAC, click on run, and go to the simulation once results are available. And first thing you need to do is to do the required connections. This is the red flag is connected. Then in exchangers, this heater is connected, which will work as the condenser. Then go to the splitter and specify this app. Now do the required connections. The feed is entering over here. And then this one is the entering B2, then entering B3. One part is the distillate and another part is the reflux. I will just realign it. And now you see the connection have been made and the all are aligned. Now, first thing you need to specify is to give the specifications of, and you see these are specified over here, 30 degrees centigrade, 1.2 bar, 100 k mole per hour, with mole fraction of methanol and water as 0.5, 0.5 each. Then click on this column, specify number of stages is 19, with condenser type as none, no condenser. And you need to provide the reflux to this column by externally. No condenser, reflux is provided by external feed. Repolar is present, valid phase is vapor liquid, convergence method standard. And in operating specification, you need to specify the reboiler duty, which is 1.80261. And you see, you can't specify the other stream because there is only one reboiler, no condenser. If there will be a condenser, then you will be specifying the second operating specification. Then go on the streams and on stage S1, which is your feed, it is entering at 14th stage. And this reflux, it will definitely enter at stage number 1. So this is ticked as well. Go to this pressure. And after that, click on this B2. And here you have to specify the pressure, which is 0 bar, because the pressure will remain the same. In this case, we are considering it and vapor fraction is 0, which is showing that all of the vapors which are going to this B2 are condensed. And then this B3 block, which is the split block. And you have to specify the value of this S5 because it is the reflux. And the value of it is 150 kmol per hour. So once after giving the values, simply run it. And once after running, you see the results are available with errors. Click OK. Go to this B3 and block B3 is not in mass balance. But there is another error which is related to solver. And when it is related to solver, it means one must increase the number of iterations to achieve our required task. Failure to solve phase adiabatic problem, etc. Warning, convergence block not convergent, 30 iterations. Convergence block didn't converge normally in the final pass. So now what we need to do? We need to go to this B3, which is the split, because the actual issue appeared over here. So in B3, go to input and in the flash options, the maximum iterations, take it to 200, for example, and then again run it. And you see results are available. So this was basically related to the iterations. In the first case, you didn't specify tear stream, then you specified the give, and then you gave the initial estimates, it was done. Here, you have given initial estimate of flow rate, it didn't converge, you have increased the number of iterations, it has converged. There are two scenarios basically of converging the tear stream. So that's how the tear stream is converged. Thank you so much from this lecture. Till then, it's goodbye.